Rajesh, you know, historically we always pay disproportionate time and attention to the quarter gone by, and we pay very little importance to the qualitative guidance. So let me do it differently. I'll not talk about the quarter gone by because the quarter gone by was a differentiated quarter. But I want to pick up a comment which was there in the press release, which was there at the press with the analysts also. You've come out and made the following remark that the COVID downturn is behind and you are confident of a reasonable recovery in the second half of this year. Now, that's a powerful comment, Rajesh, coming from someone who is managing a company of the size of TCS. What is your definition of recovery? Is it price? Is it revenue? Is it margins?
I think what we had called out in the beginning of last quarter or this quarter or the end of last quarter, that this quarter will be the peak impact of the COVID crisis. And this is pretty much along the same trajectory. So when we're talking about the path to recovery, the first step is a path towards positive revenue growth from the bottom that we currently have. So we believe that starting from next quarter, on a quarter-on-quarter basis, we should start to see positive revenue growth and slowly trace our way back to where we left off. Currently, we are expecting that in rupee terms, by the third quarter, we should get to same levels as we were at end of last year in the December of last year. And if with that trajectory, on a constant currency basis, also get to flat year-on-year by Q4. So that's the trajectory that we think is overall possible. And it's coming from the nature of conversations that we are having with customers. This last 3 months has been amazing, whether it is from a TCS perspective and the way our associates reacted, the entire organization came together very rapidly to completely retool itself into a totally new operating environment. The speed at which it has done is remarkable. But a similar story is playing out across many organizations globally. So many of our customers, they are all taken the blow. Some of them are critically injured. But other than those, everybody else is recalibrating and is again leaning forward. And we are strong partners in that journey. And we feel that that is the path which will allow us to start on this recovery that we are talking about.
Rajesh, I distinctly remember when we met last, which was July, and you said, look, this is not a crisis like 2008. In fact, Indian IT companies like TCS are in a much better model. Now, markets, I'm sure, will respond to the guidance what you've shared. But my follow-up question would be that at a time when the crisis is not normal, we know that number of cases are rising, we don't know which way global economies would move, what gives you a confidence to call out a recovery? Because Rajesh, TCS is a conservative management. If a conservative management is making a comment, it must be a thought-through comment. So I'm just curious with another follow-up question here, because if world is not normal, why do you think things will improve?
It's a very important question, Nikunj, and this has come up multiple times during last quarter also. So we have to be careful about what we are saying. We are not predicting what the future is. We are sharing with you what is the trajectory that we see based on the conversations that we are having with our customers. And based on this, as I said, we believe that there is the optimism is justified in terms of the upturn in revenue growth that we expect starting from Q2. That does not in any way preclude the unimaginable things that are currently unraveling all around us. So you need to take everything in perspective. We believe that what we are sharing is an important data point that is of value to all our stakeholders. The environmental data points that are coming, we don't have anything incremental to add to it. I am not saying that if the pandemic were to continue to unfold the way it is, or if it were to further spurt, it will not have any impact on what we are saying. This is just a point of time, data point from our side that can help each of our stakeholders make their own independent informed judgments. So I believe that this is important in such situations, because in normal times, there are enough data points and enough analysts, and the normal ups and downs of business, different risk-taking appetites will make their own judgments based on that. Right now, in an extremely volatile environment, we have a responsibility to all our stakeholders to transparently share what we are seeing. So that's the perspective with which we are sharing what we are seeing. And more importantly, this is the same perspective with which we are structuring ourselves as an organization. So as I shared, based on the expected recovery that we are seeing, we are switching from zero lateral hiring to selective hiring across markets. So we are ourselves changing our stance, and we are sharing that transparently with all of you.
Rajesh, let's also talk about work at home. Work at home is something which TCS has adopted to. You've already given a guidance in terms of how much of your workforce will be migrating to work at home. How will work at home permanently change travel, the onshore offshore model, and also what will happen to your SG&A costs?
Because we had actually briefly discussed this last quarter also on, in the same program. As I said, this needs to be seen in some from a perspective of a long-term trend. So as you think about the way work has shifted, the remote work and the ability to execute remote work at increasing levels of quality through the leverage of technology and optimized project management systems that are made to suit such an environment has been the hallmark of TCS's success and the thought leadership that we have exercised in this industry. So whether it be the original concept of integrated on-site offshore delivery model or the global network delivery model that we pioneered with multi-location delivery capability, or more recently what we call the location independent agile that we pioneered to actually adopt agile as a basic delivery framework but still integrate that with a distributed workforce. So we have been systematically every few years pushing the boundaries and redefining the art of the possible in terms of what the new working environment looks like. So it's the SBWS operating model that we are rolled out is in one form a logical extension of the journey that we are in, and in another way it is another very big milestone in this progression. And it's very important to understand that just as differentiation in the global delivery happened by not thinking of the given location independently, not thinking of offshore as offshore only, but by having project management systems that will integrate both on-site and offshore, thinking through work distribution from on-site to offshore, quality management systems, etc. Similarly, this is not about work from home. That is why the holistic framework that has been rolled out, which we're calling SBWS, is so important, because it needs to be seen in toto rather than just as a single location that is linking to the network. So we are quite excited by it. In some ways, as I said, it's a logical extension of the journey we were in. But in many other ways, it is completely opening new frontiers. And the most exciting aspect of it is actually what it does in terms of the way talent is deployed. And project organization per se will fundamentally change. And that is the most exciting aspect of it, what we call talent fungibility. And the remaining aspects of it are yet to be figured out. I am not even sure whether what the impact from cost benefit perspective will be. But anything that results in fungibility of key resources or any form of resources, whether it is cloud, whether it is network virtualization, has always resulted in greater efficiency and growth. So we are quite committed to this journey and very, very excited the more we see it.
So I'm going to ask a closing comment from you, Rajesh. How has life changed for you? I mean, for someone who would travel 60 to 70 days in a quarter, now work at home and, very little travel or no travel actually for the quarter gone by. How has life changed for you?
it couldn't have been better than this. You know, eat on time, sleep on time, you get to spend time with family. So it has so many benefits. The point is, all of us, when many of our clients that we're talking to, we are all asking ourselves, why didn't we think of it earlier? Because the enabling technologies existed. You know, today we said that our executive connect has gone up 3x. Video conferencing is not something that got invented in 90 days ago. So all of us are turning back and saying, oh, this is a great way of working. Why didn't we do this earlier? And that's the perspective at a personal level also.